As COVID cases continue to skyrocket because of the Omicron variant, Central Indiana prepares to host the College Football Playoff National Championship. Health experts weigh in on how to keep Hoosiers safe leading to the huge event. Plus, President Biden and Indiana leaders reflect on the January 6th insurrection, where the investigation stands now. And a new session underway at the Statehouse, the governor and both parties outline their plans for the new year. It's all ahead right now on this week's edition of In Focus. COVID-19 trends are still on the rise here in Indiana. You can see how every county in the state is at the highest or the second highest category for community spread. With the number of Omicron cases continuing to grow, officials are asking Hoosiers to take every precaution to keep themselves out of the hospital. Aaliyah Blackburn explains what some think is driving this latest surge and what's next.
We're now approaching our peak levels of inpatient activity for the entire pandemic.
And that's what hospitals are seeing as Indiana continues a massive winter surge. And doctors think one thing is behind it.
We do feel that this is likely being driven by Omicron cases.
Even though the State Department of Health still shows Delta as the dominant variant, hospitals say that's because they're waiting on updated numbers. Still, health officials know the virus spreads quickly.
This variant is much more contagious than the previous one, at least 2 to 3 times and maybe more than that.
And health officials feel the winter season isn't helping contain the spread.
Some of it is the weather, people are inside. Some of it is the holidays and large gatherings that people have been around, but some of it's the virus itself.
And though everything isn't bad news, Dr. Paul Driscoll with Franciscan Health feels the next month could start to turn things around in the pandemic.
The current modeling that we're seeing suggests that optimistically, the Omicron surge may peak by the end of this month and then start to drop down.
However, health officials are quick to admit, as we've learned with this pandemic, things could change at any moment.
We got a month or two ahead of us. It's going to be very tough.
That was Aaliyah Blackburn reporting. Meanwhile, the CDC is standing by its guidance that patients who become infected with COVID can stop isolating after 5 days if they are asymptomatic or feeling only mildly ill. They are still not required to get a negative test result first. The CDC added a caveat saying if someone, quote, has access to a test and wants to test, they may, and those who test positive should isolate for another 5 days. The CDC is also encouraging people coming out of isolation to continue wearing masks for an additional 5 days. The 2022 legislative session is officially underway at the Indiana Statehouse. A bill to limit vaccine mandates is on its way to the full Indiana House for a vote. It requires private employers with vaccine mandates to also offer a testing option to workers who don't want to get vaccinated. Kristen Eskow has more.
A bill to limit vaccine mandates by private employers on its way to the Indiana House. House Majority Leader Matt Lehman is the bill's author.
I think the bill's in a pretty good place right now.
Lehman's bill would require private businesses with COVID vaccine mandates to allow employees to opt out if they agree to weekly testing. Lehman added an amendment that would allow workers who are denied exemptions from vaccine mandates to apply for unemployment benefits, and that employer would be solely responsible for the cost of those benefits for their dismissed employees. Leaders of the business community say it would further discourage vaccine mandates.
I don't think employers should be penalized for terminating employees who refuse to get vaccinated or submit to weekly testing.
Lehman says he's willing to consider changes to who pays for those unemployment benefits.
I think we still have to keep some form of a trigger that says if I'm fired over this, that I'm automatically qualified for unemployment.
The amendment also expands exemptions for natural immunity, allowing COVID-19 survivors to opt out of a vaccine mandate if they submit test results showing they have a certain level of antibodies. Democrats say they're disappointed the bill is moving forward in its current form.
Let's get rid of this crazy stuff about telling employers that they don't know how to keep their employees safe within their workplaces.
Speaker Todd Houston says the full House could vote on the bill as soon as next week.
We aren't stopping the spread. Vaccination protects me. It protects me. It doesn't mean that I can't give it to you.
The bill also requires employers to cover the cost of testing. Lehman's amendment would also allow business owners to apply for reimbursement from the state. That's something some business community members say is at least a step in the right direction. Meanwhile, this past week, Governor Eric Holcomb laid out his agenda for 2022. Among his goals, Holcomb wants to cut taxes for businesses by eliminating the 30% business personal property tax floor on new equipment. He says he's also focused on education and wants to ensure children are better prepared to start kindergarten. Holcomb also wants to bring more remote workers to Indiana and look for other ways to strengthen the state's workforce.
We also know that just like every business out there, having talent is paramount to your success. I want to make sure that we're able to retain and recruit the best talent to state government. This is going to require an investment as well.
Governor Holcomb also wants to help local governments strengthen their cybersecurity. He also wants to expand the state's law enforcement training board to include more civilians. Governor Holcomb and other state leaders began the session this past week by praying for public servants, health workers, and the media in the year ahead. After the prayers, it was down to business for state lawmakers. Democratic Party leaders laid out what they want to see happen this year.
Let's think about what Indiana could be. Let's put the welfare of Hoosiers first.
House Minority Leader Phil Giaquinta says he doesn't want to see the state sit on its surplus. It's expected to reach $5 billion this year. He's calling on lawmakers to use that funding to tackle several issues, including child care costs, student loan debt, and climate change. He also wants the legislature to consider paid family leave and medical leave and a child tax credit.
In the past, we've had a lot of tax cuts and tax breaks for businesses. The idea is that, hey, why can't we do something to help those in the middle to lower income?
Some Republicans, including House Speaker Todd Houston, have said they want the legislature to consider tax cuts this session. I asked Houston whether he's open to considering a child tax credit.
We'll be releasing our tax bill tomorrow. I like what's in it. We'll consider all options. I'm not closing down anything that gives people back their money.
Leaders on both sides of the aisle say they believe there are some issues both parties can reach compromise on, particularly when it comes to health care costs.
I do think we have some common goals. I think working together lower health care costs, working together lower energy costs.
Because that's something that I know that both sides have talked about. How we get there, you know, maybe we have some little differences of opinion, but I think that's one issue that I think we can work together on.
Governor Holcomb has said he's against any spending of the surplus this year since it's not a year to revisit the budget. He says he's willing to look at ways to use that funding when the budget is rewritten in 2023.